Hey everyone, one of the coaches of Unger Academy here, and I'd like to welcome you to this brand new video. Now, when we use trading platforms, I mean the ones that let us backtest our strategies, we can only evaluate one equity line at a time, right? But is there any practical and straightforward way to manage more equity lines on the same chart so you can compare them more easily? But before going further into detail, if you haven't done it yet, please, I invite you to subscribe to our channel and click on that bell to stay updated on the release of all our new videos and, of course, all our new content. Hi, we are the Unger Academy, and we teach traders how to make money in the markets. Our founder, Andrea Unger, had been struggling with trading for years until he developed his automated trading method, which he used to become the only four-time world trading champion. Subscribe to our channel for free tips and tricks. While you're developing and optimizing your trading system, you open the performance report very often to evaluate the results of the strategy. Of course, you also need to look at the system's equity line, which does nothing but show the accumulation of the trades that took place during the backtest. The problem is, though, that the trading platforms we generally use, such as MultiCharts or TradeStation, don't feature any tool that lets you make a direct comparison between two equity lines. For example, of two identical strategies or of two systems that differ by just one or two parameters, because you cannot superimpose one equity curve onto the other, which would undoubtedly help you better understand the behavior of the strategy in the different cases that you're evaluating. So what we'd like to do today is share with you a very simple script that, if added to the end of the code of a trading system, will allow you to automate this comparison as much as possible. So let's go and see how this works. To explain this to you, I'm going to use one of the strategies we have already built together in a previous video. You can find the link at the top right of the screen. The strategy is called RSI Filter. It's a pretty good system for mini S&P 500, and the equity line we've seen in the other video was very similar to this one. Now let's go try and go back to the development stage when we were looking for the best parameters to use. Let's focus on the stop loss value and evaluate which values would produce the best results between $1,000 and $1,500 by comparing the results and the equity lines that we would get. First, let's show you the code of the strategy. Okay, here it is. In this case, I simply added this word, which recalls a function that enables us to export all the trades made by the strategy during the backtest. I use this function for the strategy, but you can use it for any other system that you want to create. Okay, so what's inside this function? Well, let's go and check it out together. This function simply creates a text file in our computer in a folder chosen by us. For example, I saved the file in a dedicated folder called Export Trades in my Documents folder. The platform generates a file. It calls it precisely like the symbol to which we are applying our strategy and recalls the name of the strategy itself. Then I perform an essential check. I go and check what the market position is throughout the backtest. For each bar, and so each time there is a recalculation, I check the market position and store it into a variable called markp, and then I make the comparison. I check the current value of the market position compared to the value of the market position of one bar ago, and at this point I also added another condition with the word and, so that both conditions must be verified. And this new condition requires that the market position of the previous bar must be different from zero. So what does this mean as a whole? Well, this means that one bar ago we were actively trading because our position was different from zero, and that then our market position has changed. So either we exited a long position to enter a short position, or exited a long or short position to be flat. So if we find ourselves in these conditions, and so if a trade has just been closed, we'll print the file. And here's the print command, followed by file. Then I recall the file's name in which I want to save the data, which is the name written in this line. And then I use format date and format time to write the date and time when the trade was closed. And then I write position profit in brackets 1, which is a keyword that simply indicates the profit or loss of the newly closed position. Moving forward, I also added these three lines in case I used daily bars. Since it would be a bit more difficult to use these types of conditions in this case, I used a different function called trades today. In any case, I recommend using this function for only intraday time frames, because if you use daily bars, there could be entries and exits that occur within the same bar, and you know very well that it's definitely not convenient. So that's why I suggest using this function only for intraday time frames. Now let's go and see the results of what we just did. After compiling the strategy with the word that recalls the function in the last part, we open Windows Explorer and see if a .txt file was actually generated in the Documents Export Trades folder. The file's here, so let's go and open it. Okay, as you can see, here is the list of all our trades, each with time and date values that correspond to the time and date in which each position was closed. At this point, we can import this table, for example, as it is in Excel, to keep track of all the backtests that we've carried out. Now, this data will allow us to simply recreate the equity line with different inputs and parameters so we can evaluate the strategy, not just by looking at the numbers on the optimization tables, but also by seeing how the equity line changes. So here's the example I've just mentioned. The red line is the equity line of the system using a stop loss of $1,000, whereas the blue line is the equity of the same strategy but with a stop loss of $1,500. Well, everyone, I hope that this video was useful to you. If you want to learn more about our method for developing automated strategies based on the work of the four-time world trading champion Andrea Unger, below in this description of the video, I'm going to leave you a link to a completely free webinar that will let you further explore the world of systematic trading. And also in the description, you'll find the script of the function that you can use with Power Language, so in multi-charts. Finally, if you haven't done it yet, go and click that subscribe button, please, and also click on the bell to stay updated on the release of all our new videos. Thanks so much again for watching, and we'll see you in our next video. Bye-bye for now.